tonight, ladies and gentlemen, with the hottest ticket in town. It is Saturday Night Live all over the world, and you've got the ticket for Bronx Bulls and Babes. It is America's number one sport and the greatest show on dirt. So let me tell you something, friends. Tonight, it doesn't matter whether you're 6, 66, or 96. We've got something for everybody. So you be in a professional cheering section. We're going to start off tonight's rodeo with a very simple question. By applause. Rodeo fans, are you ready? Ladies and gentlemen, before you meet the first cowboy in tonight's rodeo, we're going to start your action with a lady, with a cowgirl. And she is a lady of tremendous magnitude because she's over 240 years old. Look to the gate. Here she comes now. Oh, Lord. She is ever so lovely. She's in tremendous shape for the shape she's in. Born July the 4th, 1776. She's a lot of things to a lot of people, but friends, in one word, she's American. She's you and me in that independent breed of man known as the American Cowboy. As she waves in the wind, you can find the Statue of Liberty and the Brooklyn Bridge. She's 300 million Americans strong, 300,000 churches where our people go to worship as they see fit. She's a roar of a crowd in a jam-packed stadium. She's the hushed voice of a choir in a cathedral on an early Sunday morning. The fabric, the material that unites us all with liberty and justice. And as she waves before you and you stand shoulder to shoulder with your fellow countrymen, ask yourselves, what does the American flag mean to you? Tonight, is she the policeman in firemen in New York City after 9/11? Is she the civil servant to help us rebuild after storms, floods, and hurricanes? Or perhaps she's every man and lady who has ever served this nation proudly in the United States military. For in America, we all know the price of freedom has never been free. It is by God's grace that we live in a place where dreamers can make dreams come true. And that's why we love the colors of red, white, and blue. We ask you, rodeo fans, how many proud Americans are here tonight with us in Lynchburg, Virginia? Ladies and gentlemen, as we stand together, we take time now for invocation as well as our national anthem as we bow our heads to one another. Heavenly Father, we've been asked to make your will for the numerous rodeo men tonight. Protect every cowboy and cowgirl from injury, allowing to every one of us to earn our heads. Travel with us down the road of life that's paved with failures and hardships. Give us the ability to make the right decisions to live in your precious and holy name. These things we ask in your name and pray. Amen. And now, with a lovely rendition of our Star Spangled Banner, we proudly encourage each and every one of you to sing along your voices like a choir as a hometown 7th grade school teacher, Andrea Jacobs, brings to life our American National Anthem.
What so proudly we hailed.
Sit back if you can, relax if you can. Tonight, the Bucks starts here for 26th edition of the Adirondack Stampede Rodeo. Now, ladies and gentlemen, with a sport that brings to you 150 years of the old Wild West inside the 21st Century Arena, you get close with a friend, a family member, maybe a new friend. I want you to think about something. I want you to think about what you're looking at in the arena for tonight. Now, I promise you one thing. Cowboys do not like the looks of what you're looking at as we put the spotlights on that electric pony out in front of the bucket shoes. You see, ladies and gentlemen, the reason why we're bringing this to you before we ever get underway here tonight, as we put the light on this chair right here, I want you to think about something. I want you to imagine that you've just been told that it's not handy for you to ride a school bus because you don't have your own wheelchair. I want you to imagine that you're 8 years of age and you can't hang out with your friends. You can't do things that other children do because you don't have the money. You don't have the money to buy a wheelchair. And then I want you to imagine that with rodeo fans in the seats and Adirondack Stampede Committee and PA Medical coming together, they put the funds together to make sure that little guy gets on a school bus every day. Make sure he gets an education. Make sure he's part of society. He grows up to be a success, because when you change the life of a child, you change the world. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce you to an 8-year-old cowboy that wears the name of Austin Baylor here tonight. He's in the second grade, and he's attended his first rodeo ever.
Here in Glens Falls in the Civic Center, the home of John Deere Green.
as we say thank you to Niemer, Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, the Ola Ram, namesake sponsor of rodeo since 1981. Glens Falls National Bank makes a deposit and the money's good here on Saturday night. The Postar, our partners in media, and whether it's print or paper, they tell you that the boys are back in town. Texas Roadhouse, where the Cowboys grab the grill, along with Walker's Farm, Home, and Tack inside the 21st Century Arena. And the National Lacking Environmental Services, taking care of our bull riding, we say thank you to our family of corporate donors and partners, bringing to you the 26th installment of the Adirondacks Stampede and the Painted Pony Championship Rodeo.